Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome back to something completely different. The Steam Next Fest was all last week. A bunch of really cool demos came out, and we got to play a bunch of them. I'm going to highlight a few of my favorites this week. So tune in every day at 12 p.m. Central Time. And take a look and see what we got. Although Steam Next Fest is now over, these games will possibly still have demos available. And if not, you can wishlist them, follow their progress as they're under work, and buy them when they come out. Enjoy! Hello, hello, welcome to Goblin Cleanup. This is a game that's pretty heavily inspired by Viscera Cleanup Detail, a game where you and a group of your friends would clean up levels from an FPS game after the hero's been through running and gunning. You would pick up bodies, clean up blood spills, and try to get it back to normal before people would go back to work. If that intro song doesn't tell you everything you need to know about the game, then I will. This is inspired by Viscera Cleanup Detail, as I've already said. Instead, though, we will be playing as this cute goblin maid. Eventually, there will be lots of different ways to customize your character. Choose your gender, choose what you're wearing, choose your specific type of tools. But anyways, yeah, it's just kind of a sandboxy dungeon cleaning experience. In each of these levels, the hero has already been through the dungeon, and they've of course made a right proper mess of things. Our job is to go in there, it's to clean up all the blood spills, clean up the meat chunks that they've left behind, recharge anything that got turned off. The torches are all like battery powered. You can shut them off and recharge them. Some of the traps are powered by mana as well. But basically, here's our level progress. We're gonna clean the blood, reset the traps, charge all mana objects, put the loot back where it belongs, clean up the meat chunks. And you also have to return the restorable objects. So you see these little blue shadows are where something belongs. You have to find it in the level, and the red outlines will tell you if they're not where they're supposed to be. Pick them up, put them where they go. Oh, you can throw them into place. That's cool. And yeah. So the first of our tools is our hands. We can pick items up. We can throw them with a right click. We can drop them with X, or just place them again with left click. These mimics are going to act as our disposals, but they are mimics. Don't approach them from the front or they'll just kill you. Every time you die, do either a mimic or a trap. It leaves all your gubbins behind. So it's best not to do that. We have our slime mop, which is used for cleaning up blood. These little bucket containers will drop slimes for us. You pick them up on your spear, you just go ahead and clean up the dungeon. After a certain amount of blood has been absorbed, your little slimy fella can't take any more, and we'll have to be dispelled. So you walk over to a mimic, take your guy out, and I missed this one, but Just throw them away. Last tool we have is a mana dragon. I kind of showed this off a little bit. But you can drain mana from items. You can put mana back. We're just going to try and reset the dungeon back to where it was. There are altars to keep yourself to respawn a little closer to the action. And there are some traps you can't disable. So like this one, we're just going to have to avoid this. Or else we're going to make an even bigger mess than we already have. Up here you can see we have an arrow trap.
Woohoo!
That was close. Here's some of these golden items that we are supposed to return. Yeet! You can see these pressure plaids are gonna activate these spike traps. Don't want to get hit by those. But yeah, so similar to, well, basically exactly the same as Viscera Cleanup Detail, we're gonna try and put this all back together. We're gonna get graded on how well of a job we did. It's meant to be played with your friends, hanging out, putting the dungeon back together. God, there's a lot of pressure pads up here. And then depending on how well of a job you do, you get... let me go back to the main menu real quick. You can see down here in the lower left the number of tickets I have. And you also get... XP. Your employee level goes up, which gives you access to more and more levels. Not available right now, obviously. And the tickets as well are not used just yet. They will eventually unlock new dungeons. But, yeah, right now they're not implemented. The employee lounge has the tutorial guide for you. If you want to learn everything, you can read it there. This is how you punch out and end the level. It'll give you your grade. And when you're cleaning up blood, you can hit Q to kind of scan and see where all the chunks and the gibs are. Some of the traps will already be set and waiting for you. But while you're cleaning, you can just kind of take them apart so you can do your job a little bit safer. As long as you put it back once the job is done, then you're good to go. Doors can be locked by keys. And not everything is a requirement. These green objects are optional, but useful. If I reassemble this machine here, I believe the handle was up here. Yeah, over here. So the red and the blue needs to be put back into place. This green thing doesn't need to be assembled, but if I do, I get this cool little furnace. I can pick up my meat chunks, put them in there to cook, and now they no longer leave fresh blood splatter when they hit the ground. If you take a raw chunk and you throw it around, going to make a bunch of new splashes, which is not good, because you have to clean those up as well. But there are a lot of really cool interactions, like you can cook the meat. It's not terribly useful right now. It doesn't do anything to the mimics. We can't eat them. But it raises the question, like, what would happen if I put a slime in here? Would it just explode into a puff of smoke? Or would it turn into some kind of super-powered slime mop that cleans up, doesn't just clean up blood, but blows it to smithereens. Just like Rex and AoE. Who can say? But even more than Viscera Cleanup Detail, there's just a lot to explore in this game, a lot to do. There's progression, so it's not just a level per level basis. Oh my, look at that. He doesn't even absorb it, he just destroys it. And it works in an area? My goodness. What a special boy. Yeah, I don't need to show you everything. We're not going to go for a perfect run. The fastest I was able to do it solo, it was like 45 minutes per level. And I don't want to make a 45 minute video right now. But if you like what you see, if you think you got some friends that you'd like to play this with, go ahead and pick it up, try the demo. Wishlist it on Steam. They've got a Kickstarter as well if you want to support them there. But I think this is a really cool game. I think this is a really good expansion to the Viscera Cleanup detail. I think there's a lot. This is a much better game than Viscera was, even though they're essentially the same idea. So if you think this, give it a shot. Try it for yourself. Tell me what you think. Goblin Cleanup. And I'll catch you next time. Bye-bye.